hormones control everything. How and how much we grow, how the body reacts to stress, sexual function, lactation, how much we use energy, and at what tempo we live our lives at. And any abnormality within this system will create drastic effects in the body. Pituitary gland is a small organ that's attached to the brain. It directly communicates with the brain. It controls all the other hormone production within the body. That's why it's called the master gland. Pituitary tumors are essentially primary tumors, meaning that they originate in the pituitary gland. They are mostly benign, and they're fairly common. The tumor does not listen to the brain, and it starts secreting these excess hormones. They can present with an endless list of symptoms, from depression to diabetes to frequent fractures of bones to vision loss or double vision. As an example, let's assume that a tumor produces excess amounts of growth hormone. They will grow out of control in a way. Feet can get larger. And they also have growth in their internal organs, like their heart. Their whole health will get significantly affected by this. There are more common diseases that create certain symptoms, and usually patients' abnormalities are attributed to those diseases. It's just so heterogeneous that there is no single complaint that patients may have. The problem is very hard to diagnose. The diagnosis is usually done by finding some abnormal hormones or finding a vision deficit and eventually getting brain imaging. There's a component of pituitary tumors that actually can be treated with medications. Smaller tumors or residual tumors or recurrent tumors can also be treated with radiation therapy. But a very large group of pituitary adenomas are treated surgically. These tumors are located at the base of the skull. And luckily, just in front of them, there's an air-filled structure called the sphenoid sinus. And to access this space, we use the nose, the nostrils. This surgery is done in conjunction with an ENT skull-based surgeon, in addition to a neurosurgeon. It usually starts with the ENT surgeon going through the nostril and getting access to this air-filled sphenoid sinus. And once that's done, then the neurosurgeon comes in and removes the tumor. Image-guided surgery is also an adjunct that we use. It gives us an immediate visualization of where we are and reflects it on an MRI scan that the patient had before the surgery. This feedback that we can get gives us more confidence in terms of how much we can remove safely. Once we're done with the surgery, before the patient wakes up, we end up getting an MRI. That MRI can tell us how much tumor we removed. Is there anything else that needs to be done before we wake the patient up? That is a very important tool. When the patient wakes up, we already know that we achieved what we wanted to achieve. The other tool that we have is exome sequencing. This gives more diagnostic accuracy, and also it's starting to guide treatment in certain types of tumors. Yale's pituitary program is a truly multidisciplinary program, including me from neurosurgery, endocrinologist, ENT, neuro-ophthalmology, pathology, radiology. This creates a lot of accuracy in diagnosis and in management and in follow-up care. Yale's pituitary program offers anything that can be offered for pituitary care in a multidisciplinary setting.